Billy Ocean, Caribbean Queen. Coming up, your love song messages are at 10:15. There's more high stakes tension when Pop Master returns at 10:30. And the worst purchases that you ever made. A lot of great music too from Blur and Billy Joel. It's Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Claire Runacres. The energy giant Shell has reported another quarter of huge profits driven by high oil and gas prices. It made more than £8 billion in the 3 months to the end of September. The BBC's Hannah Miller says Shell has more than doubled its profits compared with the same period last year.
It is less than Shell had made in the previous 3 months, but it continues a record year for the energy giants. Shell have made £26 billion so far this year, and it does really pile pressure on the government in terms of how people feel when they compare these huge numbers to the numbers that are on their own gas and electricity bills.
A new report says the world is in the midst of its first truly global energy crisis, triggered by Russia's invasion of Ukraine. But the International Energy Agency says this could mark a turning point, hastening the transition from fossil fuels to clean energy. Hundreds of thousands of NHS workers will start voting today on whether to strike about pay. Unison is urging its members in England, Wales and Northern Ireland to walk out over a below-inflation pay offer. But it's postponed a vote in Scotland after the administration put a new offer on the table. A former Conservative minister is calling for the Home Secretary to be investigated for the data breach which caused her to resign last week. Suella Braverman has since been reappointed by Rishi Sunak. But Caroline Noakes says there are still big questions hanging over the issue. The former Conservative Party chairman, Sir Jake Berry, said the Home Secretary committed multiple breaches of ministerial code when she sent an official document on her private email. But his replacement, the Cabinet Minister Nadeem Zahawi, defended Ms Braverman's return.
She fell on her sword. She didn't try and, you know, ride it out and try and hang on to her job. She said, no, I made a mistake. I'm not going to, you know, shy away from it. I'm going to resign immediately. She did that. And this prime minister looked at the detail of this case and he believes in second chances. And he's giving Suella Braverman that second chance.
The Royal British Legion is launching its annual poppy appeal today ahead of Remembrance Sunday next month. People are being encouraged to buy paper poppies from a large wall at Hayes Galleria near London Bridge to uncover stories of former armed forces personnel. The D-Day veteran Bernard Morgan, who's 98, explains why it's important to remember.
The present generation should know what the sailors, soldiers, airmen and civilians who gave their lives for the freedom that we enjoy today, and this present generation must be well aware of that.
Finally, a Scottish farmer is giving away a crop of blueberries which would normally be worth millions of pounds. After a fall in the value of Scottish blueberries, Peter Thompson says it no longer makes economic sense to harvest the 60 acres of fruit at his farm in Perthshire. So he's donating the blueberries to food banks and letting people pick for free if they make a donation to charity. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past ten.
Thank you, Claire.
Billy Boo, Garrett Davis. Boo, Garrett Davis. Billy Boo, Garrett Davis on your radio. Garrett Davis.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.